Welcome to Movie Complex. If this is your first time here, please subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss any of the latest Quibi show reviews. Now let's get into the review.
Who does your hair? No one? Me? Aren't you tired of it? All the stares you get. You want to be one of my girls?
Yes.
This came all the way from India?
Forget about where it's from. Let's focus on where it's going.
In a perfect world, a woman would be able to wear her hair the way she wants to.
It's to take over us.
Look, I cannot die today, okay? I've been in church for like 15 years. Hey, girl.
Bad Hair is a horror satire about a young woman who gets a weave to succeed in the 1989 image-obsessed music TV industry. Her new career may come at a cost when she discovers her new hair has a mind of its own. Believe it or not, there are some heavy hitters in the cast list. The cast includes Vanessa Williams, Blair Underwood, Kelly Rowland, Usher, Laverne Cox, Lena Waithe, and James Vanderbeek. The movie introduces us to the main character, Anna, an assistant at Culture TV station. She is devastated when she finds out her mentor, Edna, and the head of programming has been let go and replaced by former model, Zora. Zora asks for a meeting with Anna to discuss the ideas she has for programming. Anna makes a suggestion to diversify the VJs and create a live music countdown show. Zora is impressed with Anna's ideas and asks her to be her assistant, but only if she covers her kinky textured hair and wears a weave to fit the station's new image. Zora gives Anna an address to an upscale salon called Virgie's, and then the story begins. A friend of mine suggested that I watch this movie because it had some really interesting reviews, so I agreed to watch it too. I went into this only having watched the trailer, and I had no idea what I was getting myself into. As I watched the film, I was having all kinds of hair PTSD. You see, I'm a millennial. I grew up in an era where kinky textured hair was considered wild and unkempt. So, as a young person, your only option was to get your hair chemically permed. Chemical perms straightened curly hair and gave it an easier to manage texture. The only problem was that the chemicals are harsh and burned within minutes of application. The phrase "beauty is pain" is used in the film, and I remember every second of that burning pain. Not only did it burn your scalp, but those real burns could often turn into scabs that were very painful to the touch and itched. I was in the select group of people who had those scalp burns and suffered from those scabs. I could go into another long, horrific video of the horrible side effects of chemical perms, horror stories from friends misusing the products, and the long-term damage it can cause. Thankfully, I'm 14 years free of the creamy crack and I haven't looked back since. So, I give a disclaimer to those touched by creamy crack, tender-headedness, and bad hair trauma that some scenes in this film may trigger you. The director of this film is Justin Simien, best known for his film and TV series, Dear White People. I feel like Justin has once again stumbled upon some very interesting subject matter, and the research that he put into this film makes it very authentic. Black culture and the media have a love-hate relationship. The media glamorizes hip-hop culture, but promotes a beauty standard that doesn't include black features and kinky textured hair. This behavior was very present and accounted for during the late 80s. The director does a great job of letting the audience know that Anna has to assimilate to fit in. Anna's not doing it for superficial reasons. She's behind on her rent, needs an upgrade in her living situation, and the only way she can do this is to cover up her hair with a weave. Anna, our main character, had a bad experience with trying to chemically straighten her kinky textured hair when she was young, so she became comfortable with her natural hair. During the film, she becomes torn between altering herself to fit in and elevate her financial status, or staying true to herself and staying broke. No spoilers here, we all know from the trailers that she ends up choosing to get the hair. The weave itself represents how unnatural it is to wear the hair and the evil behind its enforcement in the black community. And in this film, there is real evil attached to the hair and a story of how it came into existence. I find the story behind the evil hair very intriguing, and the director gives you many pieces of the puzzle as you go along in the film. We follow Anna through the story as she tries to figure out how to use the information to solve her never-ending problems. Another interesting thing that Anna said about the weave is that once worn, people began to act differently around her, and because of it, the weave allowed her to be a different version of herself. It's almost like she's wearing a costume. That in itself is an interesting concept. How many people do we know wear costumes to work? How many people do we know go to corporate jobs and they're really a tattoo-wearing, piercing-having rock star with a crazy lifestyle? Or the free spirit with normal hair at work and in her leisure throws up her ponytail into a rainbow-colored bun? How brilliant to tap into other relatable subjects and expand out of the Black community and into the broader community as a whole. The only real problem I had with this film is the pacing. It took a long time for the steam engine to warm up and get going, but once the train got moving, it was full speed ahead. I know the director had to build tension, introduce a world and folklore, so I totally get that. I just think the story could have been more finely tuned and trimmed so that the audience could get into the story more quickly. For the most part, I had a lot of emotions when I watched this movie. I had some bouts of hair PTSD, I laughed, and I reminisced on the 80s nostalgia. I give Bad Hair a 7 out of 10. Bad Hair is available to watch on Hulu now, so check it out. You'll have a lot of fun with it. If you have the time, don't forget to check out our partners at Groove.com who have some sweet deals on Blu-rays, 4K movies, and movie collections. Also, check out Things From Another World who have comics, manga, figurines, and everything pop culture. If you need an affiliate marketing program, check out ShareASale. Links to our affiliates are in the description down below. Need more movie reviews? Why not check out the 321 Binge podcast where they also review movies. Need the Movie Complex channel in listen mode only? Check out the Bite Size Movie Review podcast here. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to get notified on new content. When do I post new content? Every Saturday. This is the Movie Complex channel, your place for bite-sized reviews.